Hey, what's up? Andy here. Today I want to show you how you can use the brand new features in Mixed in Key 11 to organize your samples for music production. I'll show you how you can use the new filters and nested playlists to organize your samples so that you can find the right samples much faster and boost your workflow. Okay, let's get started. Here's a sample pack. What I'm going to do is add all the audio files to Mixed in Key, then organize them quickly so that finding the right sample is super fast. First, I want to update the tagging options in Mixed in Key. I don't need to add lots of metadata, I just need to see the results in Mixed in Key so I can drag the samples directly from Mixed in Key to my DAW. I'll turn off all the tagging options and set notation to standard. I'll add the folders into Mixed in Key for analysis. As you can see in Mixed in Key, I've created a folder for the sample pack, named it, and created nested playlists for each type of sample within that folder, and added some nice emojis, which makes navigating more fun and easy. I'll now drop each folder for the type of samples into their respective playlists for analysis. I'm going to start a new track using this vocal. It's in B minor, so I'll use the new filters in Mixed in Key 11 to narrow down my search and locate samples from this pack that match the key and have a similar tempo. The tempo doesn't need to be exact, but it helps to be close, so that none or at least minimal time stretching is required in my DAW. I can preview the samples in the player, then drag and drop them straight from Mixed in Key into my DAW and keep working on my song. I'll time stretch the samples to form a simple 4-bar loop, which will form the basis of the track. If I'm uncertain about the key or if there's a mismatch, I can verify this by opening the piano and playing along with the sample. This is a great way to ensure you're always in the correct key, or even find samples like this one that show a different key but are still harmonically compatible based on the Mixed in Key result. In this case, the full song was probably made in F sharp minor, but the frequency content of this sample taken from it is in B minor. I repeated this process, adding more samples in production and fleshed out into a full song. Here it is. Give Mixed in Key 11 a try for yourself and see how much more productive you'll be when making your next track.